Telephone Road, Houston, Texas. Aunt Gertie and Uncle Grady lived in the same home there for 65 years. And if you go through that subdivision now, it's run down. And there's rental properties that are deteriorating. There's crack houses. And then there's their home. And it's pristine. It looks like it was probably 65 years ago. And every blade of grass is perfectly manicured. And everything in the garden's growing and blooming. And it's just amazing. So anyway, we brought them a Whataburger, stopped by the house. I went outside. Back then I was smoking, so I went outside and stepped into the garden. It was a rose garden, and lit up a cigarette and tripped over a knee-high statue of the Virgin Mary, the one where she's got her palms to the heaven and she's crushing out the serpent with her foot. And she was covered in roses, you know, but so I didn't see her at first. And I stood behind her, and I looked, and I thought, man, 65 years, she's probably seen a lot of things go on. So from her perspective, what could she see, even though it was just a statue? So, and she was facing down the sidewalk to the screen door that led to the kitchen, and I could see Grady and Gertie bowing their heads to say grace before they chowed down on that Whataburger. And I thought, well, there's a song in there. I mean, there's stories in there. And then when I left there, I was singing, you know, about a statue of Mary in the garden. And then and the first two verses came real easy, and I put the song away because I had no idea what was going to happen next or how it would end. And I had a deadline, a recording session, and I fell asleep. I was living in Nashville then. I fell asleep in a big easy chair and woke up in the middle of the night, and there it was. Just grabbed a pen, and then the last verse was done. So I hope you like it. Eighteen candles and a handful of dreams. Screen door slams, a baby screams. Barely 17 when she first made love with that football player at the senior prom. They got a two-room house on the edge of town. Hardwood floors, but a little run down. There's a rose garden where the weeds have grown. Gonna take a lot of work, but it's a place of their own. And there's a statue of Mary in the garden, holding out her hands as if to pray. Watching through the screen door to the kitchen, where they bow their heads to pray and ask for one more miracle today. Rise and shine at 5 each day. She's waiting tables at the local cafe. He drives a paper route in a broke down car. Got their whole life savings in that cookie jar. When Uncle Sam calls, he and Les gonna make a better life for his wife and kid. 6 months later, he's off to war. She cries out, just let him come back, Lord. And there's a statue of Mary in the garden, holding out her hands as if to pray. Watching through the screen door to the kitchen, where she bows her head to pray and asks for one more miracle today. Cold winter nights melt into May. They both write letters back and forth every day. She talks about the baby and how he's grown. Says he doesn't know when, but he's gonna come home. And one hot summer night, she was down on her knees, planting and praying and pulling up weeds. June bugs danced and the crickets sang, but the world went quiet when the telephone rang. They say you never really know what you got till it's gone, and every day that passed, their love grew stronger. She listened for a voice on the telephone. She heard, baby, it's me, and I'm coming home. And she screamed and cried and gave thanks to the Lord. Bounced with a baby across a hardwood floor. Danced outside in the garden that night, where a red rose bloomed under a starry sky. And in the moonlight, she saw Mary in the garden, holding out her hands as if to pray. Watching through the screen door to the kitchen, where they'd bowed their heads to pray and asked for one more miracle today. Asked for one more miracle today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bruno. Really, thank you all so much.
Really cool.
That's what I love about this guy, you know. He is not only a guy with humor and can party every now and then, he also has really deep going lyrics sometimes, and he's writing that stuff out of his life, so that's what I love about him.
All I got to play are the good ones for you. I got really a bunch of bad ones.
Oh, boy. Thank you, buddy.
That was cool.
Yes, thank you.